Hey, everybody. Christmas time is upon us. Thought maybe I would look through a vintage Christmas catalog. Now, this one is not a Sears wish book. It's a JCPenney big gift book. Very similar . And this is from the year 2000. So this catalog is 20 years old. I remember when the Mac computers look like this. Now, many of you in my audience are in your 20s, so this catalog might be right up your alley. Some of you may have actually had this Jeep or that Jeep. This battery operated cars the kids could ride around on. My son had a little red Jeep similar to this, but not quite. There's a bouncing ball right there. But back in the day, those were called hippity hops. I guess that was the brand, maybe. Yeah, there's the horses. And we had one of those. There's the backyard swing set. Those were a lot of fun. And the little dykes. Playhouse. The little dykes roadster toddler bed. Yeah, I remember transitioning our kids from crib to a bed. And there's some little play furniture. And there's a computer workstation. Oh boy. There's some toys that you can ride on. Tonka. Tucker, my talking truck bot. If you see any of these toys that you had when you were a child, tell us in the comments. That's a sweet little activity desk. Everyone remembers this guy. Yep. Barney. Yeah, I remember these. What are these called? Teletubbies. Teletubbies. Marvin the Martian. There's Tweety Bird. Rocky and Bullwinkle. Snoopy. There's the Scooby-Doo Mystery Machine. There's a tent of some sorts with Winnie the Pooh and Eeyore on it. Here's the baby dolls. What is this? Holiday Brandy doll. Every Christmas I used to buy my daughter one of those holiday Barbies. Lots and lots of dolls. We bought our granddaughter a doll for Christmas that looks very real. My wife ordered one of those dolls that looked very real, and what she received looked nothing like what she had ordered. She finally figured out that she'd been taken to the cleaners on that. She paid for it with PayPal, so she got her money back. And she went ahead and did her due diligence and finally received from another seller the doll that she actually wanted. So we kept the first one and gave it to my granddaughter. Sometime, you know, a couple of weeks ago, before Christmas. And she picked it up by the hair of its head. And she was standing there with a fistful of hair that had just, I mean, the hair just came right out. The doll was laying on the floor, and she was standing there with a fistful of doll hair. You would think that you'd be able to pick up a doll by the hair. But not in this case. There's a little vacuum cleaner. The dirt devil. The Baskin Robbins ice cream maker. There's a little Tyke's kitchen. Another kitchen. There's the plastic horses. I remember my sister used to collect those when she was a kid. There's the Bob Ross Master paint set. Wow. There's the Susan Shiwi Deluxe Acrylic Paint Set. And there's some telescopes. My wife and I stepped outside last night and looked at the conjunction of Saturn and Jupiter. I no longer have a telescope, so I had to use binoculars. It's just not the same. I really do miss my reflector telescope. I still have all the eyepieces. So maybe someday I'll get another telescope. There's the Revell Visible V8 engine kit. That's pretty neat. You can build it and kind of see the parts inside of it. Gives you a really good idea of how a V8 engine operates. There's a magic kit. And a skeleton. Oh, there's the AFC NFC. The NFL Super Bowl. Electric. Yeah. Electric football. Now that's the Monday night football. I had one of these. It really looked the same. I no longer have the vibrating field. I've still got all the little men. Got them in a box. And there's a little billiards table, a little pool table. There's a soccer table. Table soccer. I guess it's a foosball table. Back in my teens, I used to be a pretty good foosball player. Some little musical instrument. Drum pads, little piano. Reminds me of Schroeder's piano from Peanuts, you know, Charlie Brown. This was a very coveted thing when I was a kid. Walkie-talkies. And G.I. Joe's. I think they're as tall in the year 2000 as they were when I was a kid. When I was a kid, they were about 12 inches high. Yeah, I remember the Foot Locker that you could keep all your accessories in. Action toys, military stuff. And rescue vehicles. There's a farm set. It's little costumes for the kids. Now we're starting to get into the cool stuff. There's the WWF SmackDown wrestling ring. Yeah, in 2000, these wrestling toys were all the rage. It was crazy. There's a BMX bike, or BXS bike park, with all the ramps, and there's a little bicycle included. Let's get a good look at this bike. Some of you have mentioned that you like to see me use the magnifying glass. And, I wished I didn't have to use it, but it does help. This was my grandfather's. After he passed away, my father used it. And these days I use it. Tops, football cards. Tops, Major League Baseball cards. And we're getting into the Hot Wheels. Go-kart racing set. And some die-cast replicas. There's a 65 Pontiac GTO. I think GTO stands for Gran Turismo Omlingato. I think that's Italian for high performance touring car suitable for competition. GTO. Gran Turismo Omlingato. And there's the little slot car sets. When I was 13 or 14, I had a slot car set. It was mounted on a big piece of plywood. And there's some radio control boats. We're getting into the trains. The radio controlled vehicles, these trucks. There's a radio controlled motorcycle. Oh, and a snowmobile. That's pretty neat. And airplanes. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Connects. A Legos. There's some Lincoln Logs. Of course, they call them Timber Logs here. I guess that's an off-brand. And roller skates, inline skates. And skates for the roller rink. Now, I used to be a pretty good roller skater once upon a time. And my dad was too. I've still got his skates. Some hockey skates. Used to go ice fishing with my dad out on the lakes. If I got tired of fishing, I just put my skates on and skated around. Boy, there's a lot of inline skates in this catalog. And there's the skateboards. I used to do a little bit of that back in the 70s before the skateboards got as sophisticated as they are now. Yeah. Football uniforms. There's a kid in a racing uniform. Some Green Bay Packer football and a Green Bay Packer cap. Here's a kid in a Brett Favre number 4 Packers uniform. A youth exercise bench. And some street hockey equipment. Hey, there's a pogo stick. Boxing buddy. Something to box. Snowmobile sled. I don't see any of the conventional sleds like we used to use when I was a kid. Now we're getting into the electronic games. Learning games. Dynamic dominoes. play TV, ping pong, or baseball. There's a VHS player. How many of you still have a VHS player? I'm looking at two of them right now over on another desk here in my studio. My office, my man cave. And there's the Game Boy Color. Seems like I did a video on one of these. Dragon Ball Z. Flying Nimbus Cloud. Interactive Pokemon from Hasbro. You guys seen anything that you used to have? Tell me in the comments. There's a Sega Dreamcast. Digital cameras for kids. Video Gear Command Center chair. Nintendo 64 carrying case. There's a Nintendo 64 bundle. Looks like a console controller. I remember these robotic dogs. My private line hands-free phone. Soft and cuddly throws. And just like that, we're out of the toys. There's some bedding. Winnie the Pooh bedding in 102 Dalmatians. Coca-Cola bedding. John Deere bedding. And we're getting into the sports related. Some NFL bedding and college football and NCAA stuff. There's some nice Green Bay Packers bedding. Getting into clothing. I'm going to kind of skip through the little kids' clothing. Jerseys. Iverson, Williams, Bryant, Garnett, Carter. There's some NFL windsuits. And there's some nice NFL jackets. Getting into the sneakers. And now we're into coats. I don't know enough about the little girl's clothing to really comment much. Here's the women's clothing. What she got in her hands, like a gigantic butterfly. Yep, that's exactly what it is. A giant butterfly. Another butterfly. Two butterflies. Seems like an odd thing for the photographer to put into the shots in a Christmas catalog. Yeah, I know. This clothing is boring. But it shows you how people dressed 20 years ago. What's it like? Leather pants. Flared legs. Almost look like bell bottoms. Pajamas, loungers, slippers. Boots. Now we're getting into the men's stuff. Sweaters with dogs and fish on them. Wrinkle-free twill pants. Corduroys. And more corduroys. Leather jackets. Coats and vests. Jeans. Sweatshirts. Ah, nice motorcycle. Windsuits. Sportswear. Pullovers. Jerseys. Caps and long sleeves. Racing jackets. sneakers. Pajamas. What are we getting into now? Gifts. Wine thermometers and electronic dartboards. There's some little football helmets. I've got quite a few of the little football helmets myself from the 70s. Little plastic gumball football helmets. Cost of a quarter each, I think, back then. It's an NFL pool table. Whimsical gifts of light. Go back a page. I saw something. Candy. John Deere gifts. And puzzles. More puzzles. Globes. Handheld electronic games. Chess. Backgammon, cribbage, dominoes, darts, checkers, and chicken soup for the kid's soul. Helmets, autographed baseballs, sports blankets, sports furniture and beanbag chairs, waste baskets, sports sleeping bags, footballs, metal detectors, telescopes. More telescopes, binoculars, mini bikes. BMX bicycles. Exercise equipment. Recumbent cycles and weight benches. Makeup mirrors. Foot baths. Electric shavers. Massage pads. Luggage. Photo boxes. Nice decorative lamps. Clocks. There's some cuckoo clocks. Collectible dolls. More collectible Barbies, baby dolls. Expensive baby dolls. More collectibles. In the nativity scene, Christmas ornaments. Stockings all hung by the chimney with care. In hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. And yard decorations for Christmas. And a Christmas costume for Santa Claus. I still remember my uncle dressing up as Santa Claus and letting us kids see him from the top of the steps. We were looking down. We did not, we did not know it was him. We went for many, many years not knowing who that was. Of course, when we were small kids, we thought it was Santa Claus. I was glad my parents did that for us. And we did the same thing, my wife and I, for our kids. We got someone to wear the costume. And let the kids get a sneak peek of Santa in the living room, eating the cookies and stuff, drinking the milk. Nice festive Christmassy tablecloths. Nice silverware for the Christmas get-togethers, which won't be quite normal for a lot of people this year. And there's some kitchen appliances. And some Thomas Kincaid rugs and nice holiday bedding. Yeah, very, very Christmassy. Blankets. And some computers. I remember these compacts in this particular case that they came in. We actually had, I bought two of those, one for myself, one for my wife. And some more computer stuff. So we're winding on down. Some electronic organizers, iMac, wireless phones, back when, you know, we still had landlines for the most part. Some electric guitars, and drums, and whatnot. Pianos, keyboards. Nice radios. CD, portable CD Walkmans. And little TVs. Stereos. DVD players. TVs, you notice that they're still big glass tubes, CRTs, cathode ray tube. Yeah, I guess this was before the LCD flat screens of today. And VCRs. All looks very, very familiar. Cameras. These were still film cameras. Here's some digital cameras. The Mavicas. I still have a Mavica. I think it might be, what is this one? Mine is, I forget the model number. I might recognize it if I saw it, but I don't see it on here. It looks very similar to this. And these, like this one was $700 back then. Uses a 3.5-inch floppy disk. The picture quality was not good. Not good at all. And camcorders. I still have one. I can look over my left shoulder and I see it. It's sitting in a glass case. Anyway, you're probably asleep. Hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. Merry Christmas.